Hello everyone, welcome back to Conquer College Admissions YouTube channel. My name is Julie Kim and I'm a graduate of USC and Harvard, now mentoring and guiding high school students to get accepted into their dream Ivy League and top tier colleges. If this is your first time visiting my channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button on the bottom so that you will be notified when I release videos every single week. Hello, I am so excited to share this training with you all. And for those of you who don't know what a passion project is, I encourage you to check out my YouTube channel. There I talk a lot about passion projects and share the different types. And one of the videos is called Five Types of Passion Projects. And the reason why I want you to watch that video after this training today is because today I'm going to be talking about one of the passion projects that we label as research assistant positions or intern position. And that is usually passion project type 2. So let me share with you why my students work on this research assistant position or with any passion project to begin with. It's very important that you're sharing your passion and your academic interest and your personality and your values in your application. Because the thing is, as you guys know, Ivy League and top tier admissions is not easy. It's important that you stand out, but it's also important that you stand out with who you are, what your passion is, not trying to fake something or not trying to look unique, but to just really show who you are. And that personal connection is what gets college admission officers to say, yeah, we love this student, right? So the very first thing that I first want to talk about is that most students will attend about 1 to 2 summer programs, or they will volunteer after school or at senior centers or at the hospital, or even participate in some random research. And the reason why this is the biggest mistake is because you have to also realize that your competitors, people who are also, you know, really aiming for Ivy Leagues and top tier, they're also attending these programs too. So will this one program help you stand out? The answer is no, right? And then there are also some students who are like, oh, you know, I'm gonna work at my dad's friend's like lab, or like my uncle's like hospital or whatever, right? And then I would ask the student, okay, so what does this experience have to do with your theme? Because as you all know, if you've been following me for a while, without a theme, you don't have a strong application. So why do you do these things, or, you know, shadowing, why do you do them? And the answer is, I don't know, shouldn't I be doing something like that? Shouldn't I do something relevant to my academic interests? The answer is no. What you're participating in really needs to show your personality. It really needs to highlight your strength. Right? So if my student's strength is writing, we go 100% all in on writing. If my student's strength is to be vocal and to be out in front of people and talk and doing, then we're all about that. So this is what most students do. I think we really need to change the paradigm here, because when you do this, which I also fell into when I was in high school, and that's why I got so sick my junior year and couldn't take my finals, and that's for another story. But this is not how you should be navigating your college admissions journey. And plus, it doesn't work. So yes, you might be wondering, like, well, aren't these like good activities and opportunities? Shouldn't I just like participate in them? I mean, it's gonna give me something to add to my application, right? And as you see in this screen here, while they are great opportunities in general, it's not an opportunity that was just meant for you. And that is exactly the reason why I have all of my students inside my programs reach out, network. And I know what you're gonna say, how do I reach out? How do I network? I emailed some professors and they all rejected me. That's because you're doing it wrong, right? Inside our programs, we teach our students how to do it correctly. And our students get awesome results. They get research assistant positions, they get recommendation letters, they get to partner up with the professor. There's so many different ways how my students are creating their own opportunity. I'm gonna share with you why this is so powerful, before I even start talking about research positions and recommendation letters, landing your own research assistant position, landing your own internship, landing your own whatever opportunity that aligns with your theme shows more than just, hey, like I have this position on my extracurriculars. It shows why you wanted this opportunity, this research position, right? So for example, I can say something like, I'm so interested in education, but specifically, I want to learn about why kids starting in third grade, their literacy level starts to go down. That was really my research interest when I was attending Harvard. And so I want to learn about that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to reach out to professors in the right way, using the right strategy. And I'm going to visit the professor. I'm going to work in their team. I'm going to be a part of their research. I'm going to do everything. And so it shows me your why, right? And every time I hear college admission officers speaking at Dartmouth or Stanford or wherever, they always say, you know, we really wish that students would share more whys with us. It's so easy to enroll in a summer program. It's so easy to participate in sports. It's so easy to participate in what's already been given. But what we really want to know is, why is this important to you and why did you do it, right? So it shows that value or and that strength of yours that nothing could really replicate, right? And then the second thing is that when you work with professors, you are going to get amazing rec letters. And that's given that you guys had a good relationship. Let me tell you a story. I figured out that networking and reaching out is really the best way to stand out because I've experienced it for myself. And when I reached out to this professor at USC, I went to his office and I was telling him about what I was passionate about. And he invited me to a UCLA event where the dean of UCLA came and I was able to talk to him and hear his speech. Had I not reached out to this professor, I would have never had this opportunity. And basically, I shared my research studies with him and what I really like to learn about education, all that kind of stuff. And he saw me, right? And he also knew that I was working on a passion project. And so this professor at USC, who is not even my real professor, was actually, you know, we were always contacting each other, sharing information, learning resources and opportunities, all of that. So he wrote me a recommendation letter when I was going to Harvard. And he wrote me the best recommendation letter, which I believe is really the reason rec letter and my passion project is the reason why I was able to get accepted, even though I had nothing on my resume, no internship, nothing, right? And later on, he was like, okay, Julie, I'm not going to be working at USC anymore. I am retiring. And so he was like, okay, I'm going to give you the copy of the letter. And it was literally the best letter I ever read. And you know, I've been doing this for 11 years, right? And I'm not here to brag about like the best rec letter I got, but recommendation letters, you guys, play the biggest role. Who's going to give you that rec letter who can speak for your passion and your academic interest? Someone who you worked under? Because you reached out, that is so powerful. Nothing ever beats that. So you have to understand that research assistant positions are 10,000 times, I mean, I don't want to quantify, but it's so much more effective and it's just the best way to get accepted into a school of your choice. And you're gonna feel so motivated working under a professor, working with other PhD students and master's students. They're gonna give you a lot of guidance and mentorship that you would never ever imagine in your high school classrooms. It's just expanding your perspective and your knowledge and your horizon. And when you have that, when it comes time for you to write your college essay, the level of your essay content is gonna be so different. It's just gonna be different. It's like if you've never really reached out and left your comfort zone and you've never worked at a lab or you've never worked with other professionals or professors or managers or whoever, and all you did was, oh, I'm gonna do what's safe, right? What's safe for me is get good grades and get good SAT scores, attend about 2 to 3 summer programs, volunteer a little bit, and just go to like an international country this summer because I gotta put that into my academic standout factor. If that's what you're doing, to be honest with you, that's not you leaving your comfort zone. You leaving your comfort zone is knowing that someone might say no to you, but reaching out anyway because you're so passionate about what you want to learn, right? That shows your values and your personality, which is exactly the reason why college admission officers accept you. That's it. And I think for some reason, this college admission industry has it, or they continuously say things like, you need to do more, you need to get awards, and blah, 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 all of these kind of other things, when I am the full proof that you don't need all of those things. You just need to be who you are, show evidences for that, step outside of your comfort zone, do what's scary, be yourself, explore your passion, reach out to professors, reach out to PhD students, and just do that. And that act itself shows that you are a self-starter, that you're intellectually curious, you are mature, you are independent, and many more. And you know, a lot of my students who get accepted into Ivy Leagues and top tier, they write about rejection letters all the time. I got rejected when I reached out to this person. But did I give up? No, I'm not going to. Some of my students are like, oh my gosh, Julie, the first person, because I also have my students do getting published and all that kind of stuff, and I'll talk about that in another video. But maybe the professor said, oh, sorry, we're full. Actually, that's the biggest mistake. You never want to reach out to a professor asking if you can get a position. We do it the other way inside our programs. But, you know, if you are asking the professor like, oh, I would love to meet you in person, whatever, right? And the professor says no. Yeah, it's gonna hurt because it's your first rejection. It's gonna hurt because you've never been rejected before. It's gonna hurt because that's real life, right? And so what? So what if a professor rejected you? But what you have control over right now is to learn how to do it the right way, be strategic about this process, and reach out. And when my students do that, they get research assistant positions, and they are studying and working on exactly what they are truly passionate about. In their application, what they're doing, the amount of knowledge that the student has, the passion, all of that kind of stuff is just, you can't even compare it to a typical application, I would say. And to be honest with you, I'm not just saying this so that you can get into an Ivy League school and that's it. That's great, that's one of your goals. But it enables you to start being reflective about who you are. What is important to me in my life? What is it that I want to study in college? What is it that I want to learn more about this month or this quarter or this semester? What is my goal? Because if you don't know that, college admission officers are not gonna know that too. If you don't know your theme, they're not gonna know that too. So then how are they supposed to know if you're a good fit for the school or not? Right? And I just am on a mission to spread this message to every high school student in the United States. That is my mission, and I'm putting it out there because this system is broken, and there are better and effective, and there are more fun ways to really navigate this journey. Because the reason why we call it passion project is because you're passionate about it and it's your strength. If someone told me that I had to like work out every day, do cardio every day for 60 minutes, that's not my strength. My strength is like talking. I love coaching. I love mentoring. Like my students know that I go crazy inside our sessions, right? Like I love that. So why should I do other things like joining clubs or doing sports when that is not even what lights me up? If that is not what I'm truly passionate about. And that's where I'm saying that a lot of people navigate this journey as if they're checking off the right boxes for their grocery list. This is not a grocery list, right? So I wanted to share this with you. I hope this motivated you to think about your college admissions journey in a different way. All right, I hope that you found that super helpful. I wanted to also let you know that if you want to take your college admissions to the next level, if you want to create a standout factor, if you want to stay on top of your college admissions journey, I highly encourage you to check out our membership program. It's called Conquer College Admission Membership, and you can learn more about it at juliekimconsulting.com /membership. And it's a membership program where every month I deliver a masterclass to you. So it's gonna be about a topic that you need to know and implement that month. So I'm not teaching you what you should do 5 months later or 10 months later. It's more of what do you need to do right now so that you are navigating your college admissions journey the best way possible. And I also host 2 live Q&A sessions. You'll get to see me, we'll get to interact, and so that you'll get your questions answered. So anyway, to learn more about the membership program, I encourage you to check out our page. It's juliekimconsulting.com/membership. And also make sure to join our Facebook group as well, because I also share a lot of information and strategies there. All right, that is it for today's video. I'll be back here with another video next week. In the meantime, I hope that you are exploring our YouTube channel and checking out as many videos as possible so that you are updated and educated, and so that you can also take action. All right, I'll be back here for another episode. I'll see you next time. Bye.